Well, we're at the halfway part of Movember. My mustache is growing in and supporting men's health. So I'm halfway through the month, and that means it's almost Thanksgiving time. And then, gosh, it's time for Christmas again. So hope you guys have your Christmas lists going. There's some Doctor Who sets coming out. There's some nice football card sets, hockey, basketball, full swing.
Toys,
games, collectibles, new Star Wars movie coming out. You can get subscriptions to Non-Sport Update or The Wrapper. You can order Doctor Who boxes or the new Force Awakens boxes. I hope you have a collectible Christmas. So let us know what you guys are looking for this year, and it'll be interesting to see how we match up. But this time we have a non-sport box break. This is a little bit of a retro one back to the mid-90s. Hard to believe that 1994 is now considered retro, but it is. This is going to be Series 2 of Star Wars Galaxy. A few, maybe months ago, we opened up Series 7. We loved it. So now we're going to go back to really the beginning, to the early days of the Star Wars Galaxy, and we're going to see how these cards match up against that set. So I'm going to have my assistant Lucas open up the pack, or the box. You like how you've been demoted from co-host to assistant?
Yep, makes you biting time.
Biting time, all right. You know, I can just open that for you if you want.
Ah!
Who knows where that box has been over the last 30 years? 20 years?
A box?
20 years. Alright.
Well, wherever it's been, it's now in my mouth.
So this has randomly inserted etched foil
maybe
cards.
Maybe it's been to the Grand Canyon.
And there's 8 per pack. Oops, that's mine. All new arts, all new visions. So let's take a look at this bad boy. As you can probably tell by watching our feeds, we've done reviews of the different trailers
and toys that
came out. Huge Star Wars. Fans, I can't open this.
The Poe Dameron X-Wing is really...
You'll get... Relax. Christmas is coming with the Poe Dameron X-Wing. So this is a first card we pulled out, and that is the cover to one of the Dark Empire comics from Dark Horse. And that is Princess Leia with her lightsaber.
Or with Luke.
Oh, nice. I got a... This is a production sketch of the canteen scene. Very cool. This was a cover to Marvel... are inspired by Marvel. What was her character's name? I can't believe it doesn't say. She's the new Dark Lord.
Uma?
No, she was only in the comic book. It was a fantastic character, great long multi-year story arc to get to that point where she fought a Luke. Very cool character.
This is my first card.
Oh, that's another Dark Empire cover.
It is?
Yeah.
It doesn't look like it.
And these
it
are just inspired
like
by artwork.
A trailer.
That, I believe, was the first issue of the Dark Empire card. So these are all inspired by. Now, if you get an inspired by, it's like Chewbacca with his feet up in his workshop with a little Wookiee pinup poster. On the back, they'll give you information about the artist, along with another sketch. See Chewie relaxing there? Mm-hmm. And then if you have the concept art ones, you get additional concept art and a little explanation of what you're looking at. The comic one will give you a panel from the comic and some information. And that's all the different ones we've gotten so far. And what's this say? Attention, Star Wars fans! Get Star Wars Galaxy Magazine. I actually have almost a complete run of those. And another inspired one. That's pretty cute. The little womp rats. So this is Dark Empire issue 1. I mean, look at that cover. Just phenomenal. Just phenomenal. These are such.
I got 2 in one pack.
2 of those little notices in one pack. Look.
Yep.
This is the merchandising art of Star Wars. These were used in promotional images for comics, magazines.
Yeah, what in the world?
That's the battle from Return of the Jedi.
But look.
Oh, yeah. It's kind of strange.
That's not 2 different cards.
No. All of these are like that. I didn't really notice it on this one. Yeah, so all the merchandising ones, you can see the sides kind of cut off with a... It looks like a...
The classroom.
Cloud City or something.
No, that's the Emperor's room.
See, the Emperor... It's hard to tell. It looks like either Bespin window that Luke gets thrown through. It looks like a TIE fighter window. It looks like the
Millennium
Falcon
cockpit.
Or it looks like another number of different things. That's kind of odd. I wonder if that was a design choice or a flaw. More film production. This was looks like a movie poster. Very cool.
Oh, yeah.
some character concept art.
What in the world?
What is that?
No idea, but all I know is I can see you, Superman.
Interesting about this set is it keeps the numbering from series one. So it starts off in the hundreds, goes up to 200s. Let me see. You can see Superman?
Yeah. Superman.
Oh, yeah. So what's this all about? The illustrators of Star Wars. Melanie Taylor Kent's popularity as chronicler of the passing American panorama has grown with each stenograph. Her 1982 Hollywood Boulevard front reflects her love of Star Wars saga. And it's going to be kind of hard to see, but there's a whole ton of pop culture characters in the background there.
Assorted aliens?
Yep, just different backgrounds, sketches. People? This was a cover. Look at this cover. That was the Han Solo at Star's End, I believe. What? It was one of the first novels based on Star Wars. I believe so. And The Lost Legacy, I'm sorry.
What's that?
That was a novel that they put out way back. That was one of the first ones they ever put out.
What was it about?
I don't know. I haven't read that in, God, since I was your age, probably. Oh, that's cool. Nice racing Biggs. Biggs tragically cut out of Star Wars. He had a much bigger part in the original film. And then they cut him out for time, including on Tatooine, where he talks to Luke and they look up in the sky and he tells him he's planning on skipping out on the Imperial Academy to go join the rebellion. Made the end where they join up together, and then Biggs' ultimate sacrifice, much more poignant.
And then he dies.
But I mean, the way the movie's set up now, that's a double. This is Ronald Reagan dreaming of Star Wars. He was president back in the 80s, 80 to 88, I believe. And he had a missile defense system that he thought if Russia sent missiles at us, he could shoot them down. And he called the missile defense system Star Wars.
Wow.
Much to George Lucas's displeasure, because he didn't like Star Wars being associated with weapons of war.
Hey.
Ugnaughts. Ugnaughts. Do.
What? Ugnaughts. Ugnaughts, I see that.
That's not an ugnaught.
That's Yoda.
That's an ugnaught.
Oh.
I know the difference between Yoda and an ugnaught.
I don't, because I've never seen ugnaught before.
You've never seen Empire Strikes Back? They're all over.
I have.
They're the ones who dismantle C-3PO. And then they're playing catch with his head while Chewbacca's trying to get it back.
Oh, yeah.
That's an Ugnaught. Ugnaughts. Do.
What in the world? What's that song from?
That was the original end of Return of the Jedi. It was the Ewoks going, don't, ba dump, dump, bump, bump.
Oh, yeah. What in the world?
That's another cover to Dark Empire.
Who's that in the stuff?
That's the Emperor. He had a clone. So he died. He's coming out in the younger body.
Ugh.
Yeah, it was pretty poor writing.
Yep. Ooh. You may take that. And that's a double.
That's a double.
This is a double. This isn't.
Ooh, that's cool. Is that Japanese? Nice. Very stylistic art.
Land of the Rising Sun.
That's Dagobah, where Yoda lived.
Oh.
That's Yoda's home.
I couldn't even tell.
Nice Christmas card featuring Yoda
it's
at Santa Claus.
It's Baby Boba.
Yeah, that's
looks
cool.
Looks like Baby Boba.
Cool little interpretation of
baby
Boba.
Baby Boba.
This is the scene that I was talking about. Where Chewie's getting the head back and the Ugnaughts are throwing it around. Oh, this is a beautiful picture of Yoda. Contemplating the galaxy and what's happened since Revenge of the Sith. There's another cool one. That was the girl I was talking about earlier, the new Dark Lord. They gotta put her name on it, right? Lumina, the female Darth Vader. She had two electronic whips that she used to disarm Luke, and Luke eventually had to use two lightsabers to battle her. Fantastic. This is the guy who did Gru and Mad Magazine, and that's C-3PO walking through the desert wishing he had some oil.
Gru?
Gru, it's a comic. Oh. Here's Han Solo burning his Imperial ID as he has just rescued Chewbacca. Although I don't know if that's canon anymore. I don't think he was.
Caden?
Canon. Officially part of the story. Because originally he was in that academy. Oh, yeah, that Death Star droid.
Yeah.
Yeah, they had an action figure based on him. He's in the movie for like 4 seconds and he got his own figure. Ooh, look at this. That's nice slave girl, Leia. I'm sure we do somewhere. Another Dark Empire cover. George Lucas and the creative mind that sprung through, one of the most creative people of the modern times with his myth-making and creativity. Say what you will about the prequels, there is a ton to enjoy.
Yeah, it's right over there.
And there's Darth without his helmet. What?
He's right over there.
Where?
Right there. Like Saint Anakin.
No, that's not him.
Oh.
That's a bounty hunter.
Oh. Well, then
that's Forlom, I think.
So we don't have
him. Okay. He's not the most exciting of characters.
Here's Darth Vader Corso. Without his helmet.
Oh, another one, huh? The Emperor levitating it. Nice.
Juggernaut.
Juggernaut. Ugnaught.
Juggernaut.
Romance.
Pew!
What's that? Wow. Oh, the guy's helmet's coming off.
Where?
The Stormtrooper's helmet after he got shot.
I want to see.
Mike Mayhew. I wonder if that's Peter's son.
Oh, yeah. That's cool.
Ooh, getting a little stuck together after 20 years.
In water, I'm pretty sure.
Yep, back on Dagobah.
Dagobah.
This is what someone thought young Obi-Wan Kenobi would look like.
Huh?
And it pretty much looks like a young Alec Guinness as opposed to Ewan McGregor. Oh, and then I got a foil card here. I got the first etched foil card, and this is number 8.
Number 8.
You can see the different layers of foil. And I believe when they put them together, they make a big image. Oh, that's from Marvel again. Oh, it's by Jack Kirby. Cool.
Jack Kirby.
Jack the King Kirby. I never knew he drew Star Wars. That's awesome.
And then here's this.
Oh, yeah. The shuttle approaching Coruscant. Battle. Oh, what's this? Darth Vader walking with someone.
Huh?
The Imperial Palace.
Can't see.
Oh, this is just Darth Vader.
Who's Darth Vader?
And a companion, unnamed, walking into the Imperial Palace.
Oh.
So I got one etched foil, kid. What are you going to bring to the table?
The
merchandise of Star Wars. There's a original dead Anakin Skywalker before he got replaced.
Oh, yeah.
In the special editions. Num num. Come on.
Nabby, nabby the boat.
Bump, bump. Oh, that's cool. Is that a statue? Yeah, that's a sculpture he sculpted. Very cool.
A sculpture he sculpted.
The sculptor sculpted the sculpture.
Ooh, this one's interesting. This one, I don't even think is Mark Hamill as Luke. If that is supposed to be Luke.
That's some of the original production art.
I don't even think that's the person who played Luke.
Marvel's Return of the Jedi comic adaptation. So this is the cover to the Marvel collected volume. Mm. Yeah, it's a little dark, hard to see his features, but I assure you that is him.
Oh, Wampa.
The Wampa. This was back before you really got a good look at him in the special edition, so that's what they kind of interpreted him as.
Wait. Cracking my fingers.
Cracking your fingers. All right, we got time. Nobody has anything better to do.
Darth Luke.
Yep, that's when Luke Skywalker briefly turned to the dark side to infiltrate and join with the Emperor.
What was that?
During the comic strip series, Dark Empire.
I was going to say, that never happened in the movie.
Nope.
What in the world?
That's the slave girl who gets in by the Rancor.
Ooh.
Some Jabba droids. Jabba droids? Droidy job? Oh, I don't know who that is. Bounty hunters, perhaps. Very cool.
And then Luke with his lightsaber.
Luke
with his lightsaber.
Contemplating, thinking about his father. Otherwise known as D. Vader.
Oh, yeah, Dad.
You.
Remember the Scrabble thing I did at Grandma's?
Yep. That was pretty cool. He had a Scrabble board and he did all Star Wars.
Yeah. I started off with a normal word. I started off with grill and then built off with letters. Only Star Wars. But sadly, in Scrabble is only 1K that in that Scrabble.
Is there?
Yeah. And there's only supposed to be one.
Only 1K, huh?
Yeah. So I made Luke.
Luke, what else would you have made?
Ewok.
Oh, Ewok? Well, you could have used Luke and then made the Ewok off of the keg. Mm-hmm. Had a little cross section there. Mm-hmm. Nope, that's correct. I just showed you. Iconic image right there. Very cool. They've used that image a lot.
What?
The iconic image. I think that was on the cover of one of the Star Wars Galaxy magazines as well. That's a new one. Very cool. I think we may have gotten that one before. There's Ronald Reagan dreaming again. That's from the Marvel series. That's a cool cover for the Empire Strikes Back comic collection. That's a double. Boom, boom. Ooh. Getting a little damage here due to the sticking of those two cards together.
Who is that?
Oh, that is. She wanted to make a rebellion female, so she drew him in.
There's but, already one.
Well, now, yeah, they have a lot of rebellion. What the heck is that?
Like, there was Padme Amidala and Princess Leia and the Commander Girl that we only see for, like, 2 minutes.
Yeah, Mon Mothma. Mon Mothma. So bad with names. And, of course, Sabine. And Hera.
Oh, yeah.
And Ahsoka. But back then, they didn't have a lot. But now they've really increased the number of female characters. Yeah. So
I think there's another one. Queen Amidala, Padme Amidala.
Well, Padme died before the rebellion actually got going.
Well, still, she was with the rebellion, so... She was a Queen Amidala for the Rebellion.
She wasn't for the Rebellion.
Yeah, she was. I'm pretty sure.
Toy collection. She died before the Rebellion started.
So? She was still with Jedis, which is...
Hold on now. I'm trying to remember the Clone Wars. There was a deleted scene where they were talking about forming the Rebellion, but it was cut out of the movie. Yeah, you're right.
Uh-huh.
Oh man, I hate it when you're right, because then everyone leaves comments saying that I was wrong and you were right. That's a great picture of a sand person.
Yeah.
That's another one I've seen a lot over the years. Cloud City, beautiful.
Luke versus Darth Vader.
Oh, that's, by Ralph McQuire. That's
Dad.
Beautiful
Look
artwork.
Look at this one.
Oh, that's cool.
They're all waiting to kill the Wampa. Whoa,
Tarkin.
What in the world?
Well, that's a proto sketches of what an Ewok would look like when they long before they made it.
Ooh, that's a cool Yoda picture.
Another one of the Chewie with his feet up. Nice little artwork of all the characters.
Whoa!
Ugh. The nasty little bounty hunter. There was actually Cyborg in the Marvel series. I wonder if that was who was based on. I wouldn't know the name of the character at this point, but he was in a few issues back in the day.
The end pick. Two in a row.
And I wonder if we sent in the subscription, if they sent us anything at the tops. For what? Star Wars Galaxy magazine. They haven't printed it in 15 years.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a fun little magazine though. If you ever get a chance, go through the discount section of your local comic shop. You'll probably find them. I usually pay 50 cents a piece for them. Got some doubles. Now we're starting to get some doubles here. That's a new one?
No, that's old.
Oh, is it old?
Yeah.
Han Solo again. That's that.
That one looks new. Ooh, this one's new.
Yoda levitating Luke, his lightsaber in R2.
Oh, yeah. I like that first-person view.
Yeah, it took me a second to realize what was going on in the scene. that's double.
That one's probably
not. I don't even know what that's supposed to be. Just a random alien.
Ooh.
You just, that's the story of Chewie ripping the arm off the droid. That's the Star Wars radio drama ad.
I like that.
That they did for NPR. They did a nice 4-hour adaptation of Star Wars with the characters. They added a lot of stuff to it, which was really cool back in the day. I loved listening to it. I think I paid like $60 for it on cassette tape.
What?
Yeah. Back before the internet.
Oh, this one's vanilla, for sure.
Yep, that's a cool one. Nice use of color, contrast. Alright, double. Mooney, Mooney, there's our little Boba Fett's Slave One.
Huh?
Blasting off. Shooting down some pesky X-Wings.
Hey.
Hey, Luke, how would you like to chop off some more hands, just like Obi-Wan did in the first movie? Chop off the arm of this poor creature. Yeah. That's all they do is Jedi. They chop off the hands and arms of people who disagree
and
with
them. Bodies, like Obi-Wan did to Darth Maul. He's like, you don't agree with me.
Sliced
him
right
in half. You don't think Obi-Wan's better, or Qui-Gon Jinn's better than Mace Windu. Take that!
That is actually exactly what happened, too. Oh, that's nice. This was to a game? Or, no, Lucasfilm Fan Club Magazine. I have that. That one of the first issues.
Yeah, everyone, come on. Join
Very cool.
Fan
Back
Club.
When they were just not planning any more Star Wars at the time.
Ooh, this one's fancy. No, Luke's not even at the top.
No, Vader looms over all.
Where is Luke on that? Right.
Oh, the original bug-eyed emperor from Return of the Jedi before they replaced him with Ian McKellen. For consistency's sake, over the prequel movies. And of course, Return of the Jedi.
Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure Luke was playing with a model of that.
Force choke! I think that's Walt Simonson, and it is. Nope, what? Walter McDaniel. Looks like a lot, very much like Walt Simonson work. I wonder if Walt has any images in here. I'd love to get him to sign a couple of them. Next time I go to Comic-Con in Hartford, maybe he'll be there. I'll have him sign them if there's some in here. I'll have to check it out. Let's see. That's doubles. Doubles. Oh, I got another etched foil card.
Ooh, look at this, Dad.
And this is number 9 of 9
what?
Etched foil card. So what you do is you put 8 and 9 together, and it starts to create...
Can I see?
...the image.
Oh, yeah.
So when you put them all in the sleeves, it's going to make one big scene.
Dad, look at this. Oh, never mind that.
Oh, that's the animated cartoon segment from the holiday special that George Lucas wishes he never had made.
Why?
Because it was pretty horrible.
Ooh.
Little Obi-Wan Kenobi sketch.
Slash fake sign.
Yeah, like Guinness, Obi-Wan Kenobi. No, that was actually drawn by Alec Guinness, who was... Of course, portraying Obi-Wan Kenobi, so that's pretty cool. Self-portrait. Yeah, nice hand for art. Very impressed. Oh, that's cool, Battle. He's going in. Hey, how about a little torture for your Star Wars enjoyment? Oh, that was another Power of the Force toy promo. Those Ewoks, they're bloodthirsty creatures, people. This guy just enlisted to get money for college, and look what was happening to
him. What's going on out there? Oh, well.
All right, let's see here. So, I got a Gamorrean guard charging the screen. Got the epic confrontation on Dagobah with Luke and Darth. And I got a Tales of the Jedi, one of the first expanded universe. Looking back at the history of the Jedi. And that's, of course, the cover artwork. I was never a big fan of those series.
This is
going to
take a while. This is already over 4 minutes. It's over 4 minutes. Over 20 minutes.
Yeah, you can only open these cards so fast. These are all doubles, though. I'll help you open up some of yours. Oh, that's we already did that one. We're gonna have plenty of doubles to trade. That there, you have that one.
We have that one.
Alec Guinness again. Ewoks.
That one.
Biggs.
And that one.
We have the eight-breasted woman that they actually made a figure out of, amazingly enough, and you couldn't give them away.
What?
And then you have
I thought we had one of those.
I believe we do. Yeah, we do. But they made a ton of them, and they just sat on shelves and sat on shelves. It was, I don't think they ever let the fans decide what character to be next, because it was just, I don't know. It was like an elaborate joke that they played on Hasbro. Those are all doubles.
Here you go.
Yes, see folks, we actually own one. I'm embarrassed to say.
Hey, it's just another figure for the collection.
It is. We do have quite a lot of figures.
It makes me more like the thing in the movie. Buy the toys already. Should have made them cheaper. Then they would have started buying them, just because they're from Star Wars.
Yeah, originally they just marked them down to next to nothing just to get rid of them. And even then they had trouble getting people to take them. Oh, that's a nice one of the Rancor.
And then you took one. But right. I'll take it. 2 cents, I'll take it. Star Wars, sure.
Ah, there you go. Leia's Jedi again.
Huh? Leia's a Jedi again. Yep. I already had that one.
You did?
Yeah, I pulled it a while ago.
So I know there was another one with her as a lightsaber. That was the cover to a comic book. Oh, a little Lando action there from the comic series.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we got that one. And that one.
Doubles.
Ooh, I don't think we got this one.
Nope, that's the Empire Strikes Back program magazine cover.
And then we got that one.
All right, we're on the home stretch here. Let's see if there's any other cards we need. Then I get to sort through them all and put them back together. There's the Stormtrooper's blasting C-3PO from Return of the Jedi.
Wait, that never happened.
Yeah, it happened off camera.
Oh.
There he is, blast him.
Whoa! Gah, gah, gah!
Oh, look at that. That's cool. I like that. That's nice.
Oh, Dad, we don't have this one. This one's really cool. Now, this is like the most realistic painting.
Yeah, that is a great picture of Boba Fett right there.
Is that picture or a painting?
Painting, yeah.
Whoa. That one's not from Star Wars.
Bump, 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 ba dump, ba dump. That one before. All right, last pack. Oh, that's him throwing the Emperor down the old Tube of Doom.
I already got that one.
So let's see if we can pull one more etched foil card, shall we?
Maybe number 7.
Maybe. That would be nice.
And not number 1. And maybe one that's around the 2 that we have. Maybe it's just 2 per box.
Maybe.
Look for 2.
So let's open this bad boy up. Look for series 2 etched foil cards. Yeah.
Oh, but
could be three. Maybe there's one in the pack. Open it up.
Oh!
Oh, wait, that's new. Nice, that's card number 1. Very cool. Actually, that's card number 141. Oh, that's right, because it starts in the 100s. So that's 141, the first card of the set. And we needed it. Last pack. Oh, look at all these. We need.
Nope.
What's that?
I don't know.
Torture. Vader.
Winner.
Oh, no kidding.
What?
Autographed Star Wars Galaxy Series 2 trading card. Look at that. Imagine pulling this back in the day.
How much would you get? What would you get?
What you do is you'd autograph Star Wars Galaxy Series 2 trading card. The Force is with you. This winner entitles you to 1 Star Wars Galaxy Series 2 trading card autographed by one of the talented artists who contributed to the series. The Star Wars Galaxy autograph trading card is yours absolutely free. Just fill out and return the winner card with self-addressed stamped envelope via certified return receipt to the address below.
poop?
Only this card qualifies winning. No copies accepted. Winning cards not submitted via certified return address. Offer expires December 31st, 1994. So I think we're 21 years too late to redeem this autographed card, but that is that's awesome. I can't believe you pulled that.
It's like, darn it, we're 21 years late.
I wonder if they'd still give it to me if I sent it in and said, hey, I just got around to opening it. So there you go. How cool is that?
It's like we just started to open it for some dumb reason.
I got to, I've been waiting for my son to turn 10 before I opened up that box, and he's 10 now, so I opened it and it's our winner. So I love these Star Wars Galaxy sets. I'm going to try to put together all of them. One through, how many do they have? 8 or 9? This is 2. I have some 4. Have you opened up Series 7 before?
Yeah.
So we're working our way through them. The etched foil cards are going to be difficult to get because there's only 2 per box and there's 9 total. So I'm going to have to do some trading for that. But very cool overall. I like it. I'm going to sort these out, put them in my binder while I watch some football. So thank you very much for watching the Star Wars Galaxy Series 2 box break and review. I highly recommend it. I think we paid, how much for this box? 10 bucks? 15 bucks? Something like that. Next to nothing.
Yeah.
Got it at the Philly Non-Sport Card Show. Gonna keep my eye out for the rest of them. Love the series. If you like Star Wars, there's a ton that you're gonna enjoy opening up on these. So thank you very much for watching. We'll be back again real soon with more sports, non-sports, and reaction videos just for you guys and you over there and this nice girl right there. All right, thank you very much for watching. As always, I'm Matt.
And I'm Lucas.
And we will see you again real soon. Bye.
Bye.